That the jungler just backed? Oh my, well, you're not gonna leash.
I can't stop.
Dude, what the hell? Wow, his lightweight's actually. The hell, that's ugly. I don't really like that. His new lightweight is kind of weird looking. Oh, what?
I can't stop. I can't stop.
Yeah, this guy is trying really hard to get some fuck. Oh, got me. Ooh, you better flash, bro. You better flash, broski. That dude was hella dead if he didn't flash. He's gonna back and teleport now. Oh, maybe not. Why is he level ahead of me? Oh. He's gonna flash, yeah, so I could tankily. Nah, he's gonna bag. Oh, he's not bagging it. Never mind. Thank you! Oh shit. Dude, that's. I don't like that. I really don't like how he looks now. That's just weird. That's not even cool looking, that's just creepy. I can't stop. Let me make sure I don't miss this. All cute. I'll
From executive producer Curtis 50 Cent Jackson comes the new Star's original series. James Ghost St. Patrick owns the New York Times.
Yeah, he still is probably like all the men in the world, though. I wonder if I can kill him right here. If he comes out, I'm gonna go for a kill. You ever get out? Don't miss the series of your power. This Saturday at 9 p.m. Actually, no, he healed up again. I'm gonna have to land a Q on him. If you wanna be a spaceman, I'll go test and land. But it doesn't feel incredible. Unfold the master plan. I'll tell you how high. Countdown to the scientist. This card just is getting bullied. Dun, 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 dun. I still didn't use my flash here, so I might be able to use flash engage on here. No, he flashed. Fine. Never popped my ignite. I kind of missed it, though.
I'll have my revenge.
I'm gonna be incredible. Unfold the master plan. Oh, shit. Oh! Everyone's still laughing about Morgana mid, dude. Morgana mid's a beast. Y'all people need to like give it a chance. Morgana's like one of the highest utility champs, and she does a shit ton of damage. I'm gold 5. Yeah, but like that's when I started playing season 2, so that's why I have the most fun playing Morgana, because I was like the first. That was like Karthus and Morgana were my two main champs when I started playing rank. I have like 150 games played with Karthus. Straight up, not even kidding.
An ally has been slain.
Alright, team. No feed, team. Balls. Watch out, ult. Oh, he didn't have a kill. Oh! He made a feed in his cart. Stop feeding his cart, this! Live for another day. Escape to another one. Ooh, that was so close. He almost fucked up. Literally an inch away from dying there. Live for another day. Stay a little longer. Stay a little longer. Stay. Thank you. Kill's coming up. No, I failed. He's not gonna die. Ooze! Come back! Got him. And I left in the rain every day for the same. When I awake in the morning, no, no. Let's have a look on the sun, since it's awake for the sun. So young, and we're all daydreaming now. I do have smart cast, noobs. I just have the HUD on it. I'm XQ, but I get 3 or 4 in my W, so it, oh shit. Don't have to grow. So I smart cast, but I have the it shows like the direction of my thing, the little line, but I only press once to get the cast off. So like, if I hold it, it goes like this, but if I don't hold this, I just like knowing where I'm gonna put shit down if I'm trying to be precise with like... What is my bot lane doing? Oh shit, they had a ward in there? That's not good. You're mad. I think I put a ward down there, I was dead if I didn't. Alright, that cart, this is dead. Oh, maybe he TP'd out. Oh, Karthus. I'm coming, oh base god. Oof! That shield for a save. Hey, you wanna die? Shit. That's your deal, bro. Noob. Yeah, range indicators, that's what they're called. It's still smart cast. Yeah, pretty much. If I just press it once, it just says smart cast. But if I press and hold it, then I see my indicators, pretty much. So like here, look, I'll just press it once. And my indicators come out like until I hold my thing on. No, I still have for my W. I can hold it down. I can hold any kind of ability besides my ult. My ult just comes out, obviously. We'll be seeing you. Oh, he's dead. Oh, no, he didn't die. No ult, no ult. Yeah, this card is getting toyed with. He's pretty bad. He didn't get a tier either, he's like noob. Wait, I gotta do a phone call. What time is it? Yeah, I gotta do that pretty soon, actually. After this game. I'm the best.
I'll have my revenge.
Thank you, that was very nice indeed. That was a well set up ult. And follow up. I didn't waste any abilities on someone I didn't overkill on anyone, so. Whoa, turret.
Let's do better features for fewer bucks. With savings on brands like LG, Electrolux, and Samsung, you can cook smarter, rinse cleaner, spin faster.
That ribbon's dead. Oh, not dead.
Let's do this. 10% off appliances for $197. More saving, more doing. That's the power of Home Depot. Valid through June 4th, US only, 6 store fee details.
Let's get some AP. So you put SmartCast on, and then you go to your options, interface, and I think it's all it. Show right here. Game. You on game and gameplay. Show. Or no, that's not it. Where is it? Oh, it's right here at the bottom. Display range indicators when using QuickCast. So I'm using QuickCast, not SmartCast. I'm not sure if that's the same shit or not. Could be this, should be different. Yeah, hockey's in a DM.
Knocked down.
Come here, I'll shield you! Oh, she ran away from me. Noob. Oh, fail. Oh, I have my hourglass, just a minute. I got you. Oh, they're the same. So I guess I use the same thing you guys use. Oh, this Lee's being chased down.
I'll have my revenge. An enemy has been slain. Rampage.
Why does the shield gotta be black? Because it's magic. It's not about being racist or anything. That's kind of funny. Oh, how they going? Oh, he dead. Peace. Oh, no! Oh, she got her own shield. And this guy's stealing all my CS.
Victory.
You're gonna make me cry. I'm touching my heart, but I'm gonna turn around. You that you're living a lie. Maybe cause in time you will find what goes around, goes around, goes around, comes all the way back around.
What goes around, goes around, goes around, going all the way back around. What goes around, goes around, goes around, goes all the way back around. What goes around, goes around, goes around, goes all the way back around. Yeah.
Rambo singing like, you're out of NSYNC.
Now. Yes, you do the same. One thing about that is I'm a daddy to give you my name. I don't wanna think about it. Don't wanna talk about it. Don't wanna think about it. Then I'll need it in this way. If this way, this is the way, come tone it down. Is this how we say goodbye? Stuck in my hideout and you came around, and you gonna make me cry. Stuck in my heart, watch it turn around, and I know that you're living a lie. In time, you will find what goes around, goes around, goes around, comes all the way back around.
I can't go high, dude. My voice is so bad.
What goes around, goes around, goes around, goes all the way back around.
Alright, so I'm probably gonna be doing this. I gotta do something real quick in a little, probably like in the next few minutes, so let's just do a Q&A. While you guys are still here and I'm still here, I'll definitely be streaming a lot more now. Obviously, I'm leaving tomorrow for X Games, but when I come back, I'll be streaming PC games and stuff whenever I'm able to and such like that. So, today was a good day of League. Today we did. Today we went. Oh, that 3-game winning streak, though.
Don't wanna think about it, don't wanna talk about it, don't wanna think about it, telling me that's in this way.
Who do I think is winning the cup? The Kings are gonna win the cup. I highly doubt the Rangers are gonna be able to beat the Kings, but you never know. But unless Lundqvist plays out of his mind, but yep, professional singer is my next move for sure.
Stood in my hand and when you came around, you gonna make me cry. Still in my heart, you put in the man. Because in time you will find what goes around, goes around, goes around, comes all the way back around.
So I guess your next move in your career, yep. So excited for you, Ray, finally you're back. Yeah, I'm gonna be streaming a good amount. I'm excited for you too, Killer, because you're a good bud. Can you add you on League? If I add you on League, I probably won't be playing. When I play on League, it's normally like really good close friends or it's playing ranked games. So, I excited return for Advanced Warfare. I honestly don't know. I couldn't tell you, dude. It's like everyone that asked me if I'm playing or not anymore, if I'm gonna be competing anymore. I literally do not know. There's literally like, it's just everything's completely up in the air right now. Like I'm at a point in my career where there's. I'm going to go with whatever's best for my stability. So, obviously, being with the Envy organization is something that's really good for my stability right now because there's so many perks that we have with the team right now that I wouldn't have somewhere else. So, and I also have this visa thing going on. So, it's just really like there's different possibilities, different things going on. Some things that I'm not allowed to talk about, some things that I'm excited for. But yeah, for the time being, I'm just not really. Not really allowed to say much, but for yeah, it's good stuff. Good stuff. Rangers speed might be too much for the Kings. Hell no, there's no way, dude. The Kings are just Kings are a playoff Kings. They're just too good. What rank am I? I'm gold 5.
Back home, baby.
My favorite champ is Morgana. As you can see, I play Morgana a lot.
I need your love, I need your love, I need your loving. You're the sin that keeps me coming. I need a hero trying to save me. Oh my God, I know you know how to save me. I've been feeling weak.
You come and rescue me. What does COD need to stay alive? There's no really such thing as COD staying alive or not. It's really about how fun COD can be. And right now, COD is just... I mean, Call of Duty to me right now and Ghost is just very dull. It's not that it's a bad game. It's just really just there's not much to it that's just really interesting compared to... We've been playing the same stuff over and over and over again for so long now that it's just getting repetitive, so... There needs to be a change in pace in the game. Something fun, something additional, some more things to do on COD, I think, is really what it is. I'm not entirely sure yet, Swedish, if that's going to apply to me or not. I'm not really greedy in that sense. I'm sure I might be getting something. I'll be getting the same perks that they do, but as far as like salary and everything like that, I have no idea. Right now, it's just, like I said, right now it's in talk. And there's a few things that need to be done before I can actually see if that's a case scenario where that needs to be worked with and such. But yeah, am I taking NVD LCS? Yeah, I'm definitely gonna start LCS NVD. Am I ever gonna do the bird call again? I'll definitely play it. There's no way I'm never gonna play, like, I'll definitely play COD again. Like, I would highly doubt that PAX was my last event as far as competing. The point is like, it's really like PAX might have been my last event on a team where I was actually trying to win with, kind of thing. Like, I'll probably just play an event for fun at some point. Like, just if Big T wants to play or something, like, or someone like some one of my old teammates wants to play for the fun of it. Maybe just play with a NAM team or something like that, just for the hell of it, just to compete. But yeah. Obviously, I miss competing, playing COD, and having to play, like, but I don't really miss having to play Ghost every day, I guess you can say. That's probably what it is right now. So it's not a complete burden to me. If this happened during Black Ops 2, then I'd be itching to play still, to be honest. But yeah. Predictions for X Games? I honestly don't know. It's gonna be a tough call. Our team's been looking pretty strong lately. I mean, it's really about EG. It's whoever can beat EG right now. EG's definitely predicted to win. I mean, that's really pretty hard to say anything against it. But I definitely think Envy's got a strong chance. We gotta play Curse Orange and then the winner of Optic and FaZe Red. Which FaZe Red played us online yesterday and mopped us, but FaZe Red online is something else, so it's gonna be interesting. It's gonna be a very interesting event, to say the least. Yes, I'm still at the team house. That's correct.
I am big, I can't rain. I'll never win this game without you. Without you, I am lost, I am vain.
Why wouldn't Drifter's mentality of having the pros play with the kids in pubs play? You mean played away? I'm not sure. You gotta rephrase that question in a way where it makes sense, but... Convince Envy to make a second team for you? I don't know. I'm not... Right now, I'm not at the point where I would want to do that, so... That's pretty much one of the reasons why I'm not pushing in that direction at all.
I am rest. I won't run. All I need is you and I without you.
Are you watching League of Legends and giving advice or anything like that? The League game. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yes, I have, actually. I've been watching. Since I've been back, I've been paying attention to what they're doing, playing. I've been especially watching Chris. I feel like Chris is the kind of player that has so much potential, but there's so many things that he's kind of closed-minded about. So when I come and sit behind him, and I try and open up his mind. I'm like, he's a really, really good player. So I really try, and that's pretty much my job right now, is to like, try and... make sure that they're all on the same page and make sure that they are open-minded about what others have to say, because there has to be a median. Like, it's kind of like an arbitrator where someone's in the middle of the two and will direct the conversation in the direction it needs to go in rather than just being redundant and players talking about the same shit. So if players argue, I'm there to grant who I feel is right and why, and then make them understand that, like, just be open-minded pretty much. Could an LCS type ranking system work in COD League play? I would really like for that to be a case. The only thing with that is the fact that it needs to be populated. And in Black Ops 2, we had like maybe between 6 and 15,000 people playing at the same time. When in League of Legends, you got millions, like 100,000 of people playing the ranked system all the time. So it's just like there's no, it's really hard for to be matched against people at your own rank, and for the ranking system that should be correct with the amount of people that play. I'll probably stream some more League tonight. Yes, I'm going to X Games. We're leaving. I'm flying with the team tomorrow. You don't know where to start. You've been trying real hard to try competitive, but this isn't working out. I'm 15, by the way. Not too sounding cocky or anything, but I'm pretty good. I just can't find a teammate to play with, or just always choking. What should you do? Well, the first thing is you should not have high standards for the team you have. The biggest thing this will be my last question, by the way. I need to go do something, but the biggest thing when you first start trying to play competitive and you first get into it, obviously play game battles and try and find teammates through that, but the most important thing is to not get ahead of yourself, not feel like you deserve to be on a pro team. Be very humble about where you stand. Like, play with teammates that have the same goal and ambitions as you do, so you can actually grow with the team. And it's never easy to find teammates that are good, but you'll always run into, like, let's say I join a team of three. There's normally always going to be one player, at least one out of three players, that you can find yourself more close to or more accustomed with, so you can just kind of try and grow with that player, which is kind of like what happened with me and Big Timer. Like, we started playing together, and we found teammates. We found teammates, but me and Big T switched teammates, like, at least 20, 25 times all the team together. We had at least 20 different players that were on our teams from day one to the last day we teamed together since then. So it's never easy to find a full set of four players and stick together for a long time. But if you can find a core of a player or two, like a duo, a second player or another player, like two or three players that can stick together for a while, then that'll help you grow through the scene, because then it pretty much helps you grow and understand how your teammates work, gives you a better chance as a team. And also gives you a better chance to learn and grow and play tournaments with the same teammates and kind of like grow into the community. So the best thing to do is play, in my opinion, play game battles, try and find teammates that want to play competitive matches and play tournaments, and then play the online tournaments and then make your way through there. So that's your best way to make it out right now. Yeah, pretty much like TP and Aix were... TP and Aix have been teammates longer than me and Big T have now, I believe, when me and Big T were together. Me and Big T were together since COD 4, 09. TP and Aix were together since end of Modern 2. So yeah, it's been longer now, for sure. And they've also won a lot more than we did, because they've been winning everything for, like, the past year, so. But they have, like, Krim as well. Like, they could pretty much, like, Karma's a really good player, but, like, literally those three players make that team. Like, with Clay, they want everything. With Karma, they want everything. Like, they just, like, that four player is kind of like this guy who will kill a lot of things. Like, just kind of like this really slayer that'll keep, they'll rarely have bad games of slaying-wise. And then the other three kind of do what's needed to, like, really win. One more Krim and Teep. Yeah, Krim and Teep will do that. And then Aix will slay as well, so. I'm not allowed to talk about anything Advanced Warfare, so there's really no reason for you guys to ask. Will COD be as big as... I don't think. I mean, we're a long ways. Like, the big difference between Call of Duty and League of Legends is really the fact that League of Legends at the base is a competitive game and Call of Duty at the base is a public game. So until that changes, there's no way we have a chance at being bigger than those games. It's as simple as that. It's kind of like logic. We don't have the tools. We don't have... Our game at a base is a casual game, and their game at a base is a competitive game, so... obviously there's more chances of their game being successful in the competitive level. Alright guys, that's going to be it for me now. I'm going to catch you guys for some more streaming later, probably some later tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream as always. I'll be getting more in the stream guide and playing some League and CS and other games and stuff, PC stuff wise, and obviously I'll play COD here and there. I'm trying to play some with Dr. Drew Suspect again, so yeah, I hope you guys have a great night.